We need you guys to resolve a great debate, a great show debate. The 104.5 is taking a road trip. This is like the NBA road trip pictures you see with Jeff Van Gundy and everybody else. They're all driving around in the car, the bus.
We are. We're getting a van. All of us in one van.
We're all going to be in one van. We're going to the Super Bowl.
We're like in the RV.
We need like a reality show for this.
We're going in a van to the Super Bowl, but, and this
are we
going to
park it down by the river?
I'm going to guess. Well, maybe. We're going to stay a ways away. We have one issue. We have too many people and not enough beds.
Yeah, we have one more person than we have beds.
So here's the crew. We've got the three of us, obviously, the three HL. We've got the midday show, Paul Kaharsky, Jonathan Hutton, and Chad Withrow. And then Frank Wycheck from the morning show is going to go.
All right,
that
so
is seven people. We have three rooms all with beds inside, which means
two beds inside.
So we have six beds, seven people.
And one jacuzzi, right?
And one jacuzzi.
Oh, well,
somebody can sleep in the jacuzzi. What is the most awkward bed pairing? In other words, of those seven names I just ran off, who are the most awkward people to share a bed? I'm on the record. I don't care. I will share a bed with any man over sharing on the ground.
You want the listeners to choose this?
I want listeners to choose the
most
awkward.
This is two nights in Indy?
Two nights in Indy for the Super Bowl.
Listeners are choosing which two of us share a bed?
Yes. I want your opinions. I want the most awkward. The phone lines are now going to be open. We just opened them back up. JT is already cursing. 737-1045.
He stopped T-Bowing. Now he's cursing.
Yeah, now he's cursing. It's covering both sides of the spectrum, just in case. What is the most awkward bed pairing? Who should have to share a bed?
Welcome back in 3HL 104.5 The Zone. We're posing a couple of questions this hour, in addition to getting you some headlines and all that stuff. First one.
Yes.
We are all going, well, some of us are going to the Super Bowl to cover the event for the radio station. So we'll be up there on Radio Row, Super Bowl week, with hopefully unbelievable guests. And we're going to have a great time and hopefully kind of paint the picture for you of what's going on up there. In addition to that, we have three rooms for seven people. So the question, and we asked this when we were on during the midday at one point, you know, if you're stuck in a situation, one room, three guys, does somebody sleep on the floor or are two dudes sharing a bed? We ran that one through the roof, and now we've come up with a real life situation.
It's like a math problem.
Six beds, seven people, and we've turned it over to you. Who shares? Or does somebody just sleep on the floor? Blaine's volunteered to sleep in the heart-shaped jacuzzi.
No, I didn't say that. I said, can you put some pads in the tub, man?
It'd be too easy to mess with you if you end up there, though. I mean,
well, we'll talk about what happens if you go to bed too early.
Sure, so we've all woke up in the tub and wonder how we got there.
So a lot of people weighing in, and we want to hear from you. Who needs to share, according to you? Somebody called in, couldn't hang on, said, what do they say? Paul Kaharsky will end up sleeping by himself because no one wants to sleep with him. That didn't sound good, but.
Because otherwise, we all would sleep together.
Yeah. James and Matt Hewitt. Hey, James, what's up?
I was going to first say Clay and Wycheck, because Wycheck would kill him if he touched him, but I got to put Kaharsky and Clay because that would be about as funny as a new comedy show on TV. I'd like to have video of it anyway.
Do you want video of me and Paul in a bed together? What kind of guy are you?
I like funny stuff. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, that would be funny. Thank you, James.
James calls in and publicly announces he wants video of me and Paul Kaharsky in a bed together.
Are we keeping track of this?
So, yeah, you're going to keep the score? Or I got a tablet here.
Paul, Clay, that's one combination. Andrew in Hendersonville. Hey, Andrew.
Most awkward pairing, I'd say Blaine and Frank. Just because not only are they former teammates, but both of them former football players, that's a lot of man for a small double bed.
That would be kind of a Music City miracle, wouldn't it?
How many Pro Bowls would that bed have?
Oh, no, because Frank's a pretty big guy. I think
Frank
I would
went
just
to a couple
say,
Pro Bowls, too, right?
Oh, yeah. I think he went three.
So that's seven Pro Bowls.
Yeah. I think I would just say he's 6'3", 4".
Frank's a big guy.
I just say I'll give you the bed. I'll get on the floor.
See, that's where we're going.
I would sleep. I'm in the bed.
You're in the bed. Kayla, what's up?
Hey.
Oh, did Kayla just snipe? Oh, we hate when women get sniped. I think she sniped herself.
She did snipe herself. That's
Kayla, you can call
no,
back.
Oh, but you can read what she said. Oh, okay. Well, I hope she got back.
David on the cell. Hey, David.
I would have to say Frank is the biggest, and then put the smallest one is probably Clay. But
you know, Frank's going to be the biggest, so just get him a rollout bet anyway. So
get him a rollout bet.
You think he would want the rollout bet? Is an awful decision. It's like, do you ever have to sleep on those air mattresses?
Air mattresses are bad. Rollout bed. Rollout bed, you always have something sticking you in the back, you know?
I have never.
That's right where I have back problems, so it's perfect.
I have never slept on a rollout.
Like a massage bed.
Air mattresses always deflate during the night.
What?
Every time I've ever been on an air mattress, in the middle of the, when I wake up, like, I'd have to go to my in-law's house or something and sleep on the air mattress, and I'm like, this is the stupidest decision ever. When I wake up, I'm just laying on, like, my cheek is just pressed up against the hardwood floor. And I'm like, this, I might as well have just slept on three towels. It would have been the better.
Your cheek, huh?
Yes.
Richard in Nashville. Hey, Richard.
My pairings, well, you can't put Clay and Paul together because I think they're two exactly the same people. You know, Paul is the northern version of Clay, and Clay is the southern version of Paul.
I would say I'm a much sexier version of Paul Kaharski. There are many reasons, but the number one would be
you have hair.
I have hair.
Now, Richard, that was pretty good. The southern Paul and the northern Clay.
I requested the video of y'all in the bed, make that decision of who's the sexier of the two. But,
we'll put it on the 3HL YouTube channel.
There you go. Who I would put together, I'd put Blaine and Paul together. I would just love to hear what Blaine had to say the next day, you know. And we got to find out, are these the beds that you put the quarters in the headboard, you know?
They might be. I don't know exactly where we're staying.
Come on, Richard.
I don't think we're in the high end. This is certainly not.
Okay, we're in the Hampton Inn.
Okay.
We're all right.
We're not in the Ritz-Carlton or anything.
Herman. What's up, Herman?
The problem's already solved, man. Mark Howard is not going. I put some money together. Whoever ain't got no beer with Mark not going, it's going to be a good trip.
Mark is not in the van.
Mark's the smartest man on the show.
Yeah, he will be here in studio. And Frank Lychek, when you hear him, what's Frank going to sound like on Friday morning? I bet he can barely talk because he's going to have some drinks and he's going to have to roll out of bed and make it over there for the. You guys are on. What is Indianapolis on? Is that Eastern time?
Yeah.
So that's 5 a.m. Central. Yeah. Oh, he's going to sound rough.
They call Mark Little Joe Plaster.
Mark is very good at what he does, but he needs. He is a snorer, from what I've been told, so I'm very thankful that he will not be in my room.
Well, whoever don't wear deodorant ain't got to worry about nobody sleeping with him, no way.
That's true. You just get really sweaty and try to cancel out anybody else wanting to sleep with you.
Jacob Underwood writes, Clay and Paul, they'd argue over everything from. No, I get the extra pillow. That is true. You guys would probably argue over stuff. You're hogging the covers. You know, things like that.
Whether Springsteen should be playing while we go to, after I go to sleep at night.
Alan in Bellevue. Alan, what's up?
Thanks, guys. You guys still doing good since last time somebody asked you?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. And we're great, glad that great. People asked.
I like the Brent and Frank pairing. Just that's somebody's gonna be cold. The next morning. They're just simply not the square footage of blanket seat is just not gonna cover. And I wish that guy wouldn't have stole my thunder, but anything to get Mark Howard invited. You want to talk about some awkwardness? Any pairing with Mark Howard is gonna be the most awkward. I mean, you got the apnea mask and some shrieks.
How awkward
up the contraptions.
If Mark Howard comes out of spending the night with us all in bed and he's talking about how he can barely swallow, I don't know what's gonna happen. The show would just come undone.
Are we going to have a stripper pole in the room?
Oh, certainly.
It's going to be in the tub.
Do we have the Mark Howard? I can barely swallow.
No, but he's got the stripper pole call.
Oh, he does?
Your voice is cracking just even thinking about this.
Mark Howard, if they were running that I can barely swallow ad, like the first break for after he spent the whole night with all of us in the room.
Oh, and you know what? And somebody just had something on here. I missed it. I think they hung up. Then after the first day, we have to play bed swap. Best swap. Now you got to switch who you're in the room with.
Let the fun times begin.
And the one who's doubling up gets to double somewhere else.
It's dangerous. There's no doubt at all. This is a dangerous trip.
I would just look for interviews. All
who time. Do you guys want to drive in our van too? I'm thinking the mayor. Who are you thinking, Blaine? I like you because you're going to fly. I can't drive because I almost have my license suspended for getting too many speeding tickets. I don't want to cross over state lines. I'll inevitably get a speeding ticket. And it'll be in Kentucky, in which case I'll probably get arrested. They're not giving me the benefit of the doubt there.
Oh, Clay Travis, I've been waiting for you to come.
Yeah, same thing with Alabama.
Or Commonwealth.
Going down to Alabama. I'm not driving the state of Alabama anytime for a while either.
You have the stripper pole call?
Why would you want to put a stripper pole up in that room? Like, do you really want to see Mark Howard up on that thing?
And then the remix?
whether you're on the radio or not. A sore throat is just about the worst thing you can get. It hurts when you speak or swallow. Core swallow.
I love that music.
Core swallow.
Like Herbie Hancock.
Core swallow. It hurts when you speak or swallow. Core swallow. Core swallow.
Yo, John.
Core swallow.
John, next up on 3HL. Hey, John.
Hey, what's up, guys?
I don't know, man.
I think maybe Mark should bring the water skiing squirrel from the boat show. I guess he did this past weekend or something.
That's right. I've heard that advertised a lot. That's an amazing thing, the water skiing squirrel.
It's a really talented squirrel.
Yeah.
But as far as sleeping arrangements, you guys can go vertical.
Vertical? We're sleeping standing up?
No, you get a bunk bed from Dixie. And then you guys flip a coin, see who's on top, who's on bottom.
Is John drunk?
Kind of sounded that way, huh?
About 5 o'clock, some of you guys have hit the bottle. We're going to start getting really drunk people calling about 5 o'clock.
Well, we don't know that.
I'm guessing. I mean, was he drunk was the question. You said it sounded like it, so then we built on it. Yeah,
it did sound like it. Ray in the Borough. Hey, Ray.
Hey, sounds like a fun trip. I think Paul Kaharski and old Frankie Poo are going to interact together, because I am certain before the night's over you're going to hear, where's your hand between two pillows? Those are
cool. Great movie. Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, if you hadn't seen it. Steven on I-65. Hey, Steve.
Hey, I think the predominant pairing is Clay and Kaharski, with Kaharski calling him Chief and Clay calling him an idiot. But the problem being is the third person in the room, that's the real loser.
Oh, yeah. Somebody'd have to
Anybody
listen
has to live
the whole night. Can you imagine? The whole night. So even if you're in your own bed, you're not getting easily.
Yeah, I think it should be Frank and Paul, because I think Frank would give him the old Ole kick while he's sleeping. He'd be like, "Oh, hey, I didn't even know." Then Paul just give up,
buddy.
And just go.
I didn't see you down there on the floor.
Exactly. Hey, buddy, what are you doing out there? What happened?
737-1045, 866-492 zone, #1045.
What are the odds that Frank's going to get to see his boy Cutler at Super Bowl? If we could get Cutler on, interviewed by Frank Wycheck doing the Cutler impersonation, would the world
that
just
would be
explode?
Gold. Yeah, that's like Kramer at the corner of First and First. Yes. I'd rather have Kristen Cavallari on.
Well, I'd rather see her. Oh, that was a tip. That was a layup. Kristen Cavallari is only going to go with guys who have hair. So, Kaharski, you're done. You're out the window.
Beds Are Burning, the song. Well done. Nicely played, JT. 737-1045-866-492 zone. It's a common problem. 7 people, 6 beds. Super Bowl coverage. Right here on the zone. Who's sharing? So far,
that
couple
might be a bigger story than anything that comes out of media days. 2 guys sharing a bed.
2 people have you and Paul, Clay. 2 people have Blaine and Paul. 1 guy had Frank and Clay. 1 guy had me and Clay. And 1 guy had Frank and PK.
Withrow is the only one that hasn't been used.
Hutton.
And Hutton.
Withrow and Hutton are escaping the wrath. Wanda writes, Kaharski with anybody in all caps would be awkward.
Vincent, not his wife.
Vincent writes, Withrow and Clay have to share a bed to cancel out their awkward hot tub date.
Yeah, I tweeted out the picture of us in the hot tub. It got changed to me with James Franklin, I think, and I tweeted that out. One of my followers did that. It was very funny.
Yeah, I was just reading this one tweet. It mentioned you and Franklin, Patrick McElwright. He says, Blaine should get his own because of his thick thighs, but I think Clay should split an extra 1 bedroom with Saban and James Franklin.
I do love both those guys. It's true.
Another message. Frank with any of you would be awkward, but he won't be there. Frank's going to pull out of this trip?
No, he wouldn't do that.
Frank has more commitments and less appearances than... Who is the biggest celebrity that, like, Kanye West, he has all these concerts and he doesn't show up for him?
Gary Shandling.
Is that true? I don't know.
I don't know.
Just Gary Shandling is such a random name. There's like 4 people out there who know who Gary Shandling is. You might as well just say your neighbor. Larry low-end celebrity. Kathy Griffin. I don't know. Kim Kardashian.
My neighbor, Don. One less bed problem. Cleverly designed plan by Clay and Withrow to sleep together. # hot tub love. Blaine and Kaharski. CJ writes, I just want to see Clay come back with a tattoo on his face.
That leads us to exactly
737-1045.
Yeah, I've got to somehow figure out how to finesse that story, which will be at the 5:30.
Ron in Lebanon. Hey, Ron.
Hey, guys. Hey, I got two of them for you. One is y'all get an all-in-one room and you're throwing a big party, and a funny visual would be to come up with a disturbance call, and they go up there, and y'all are up there partying, the YMCA dressed up like the village people. And the other one would be Paul Kaharski and Frank. Frank run around to this music right here, smacking Paul Kaharski upside the head.
Is that the Benny Hill song?
I don't know. It's rare we have.
Yeah, that was a really detailed plan laid out.
Yeah, man, it's rare we have music well brought prepared to us by callers. It's,
yeah, well produced, everything. Yeah. I mean, he brought it. Eric on the cell. Hey, Eric.
Yeah, this is Derek.
Oh, hey, Derek. Sorry, man.
This is what I got going on. I think we should do Blaine and Clay, because that could be your new and improved version of Ebony and Ivy.
We are going to sing that at the karaoke.
That is a good idea. Kathy writes, can you guys not just simply take an airbed?
Airbeds don't work. I just said, inevitably, you end up sleeping on the floor. I am sleeping in a bed. There will either be a man with me or a man without me.
See, the problem is that all y'all know I'm willing to sleep on the floor, which means I'm going to be on the floor. Except for Blaine threw a wrench into that by saying he was willing to sleep in the hot tub.
He suggested somebody sleep in the hot tub.
Just, okay, we pad the tub.
This is where this story all began was. I don't understand. You're clearly heterosexual. You have produced three children. You're married. Yet you would rather sleep on the floor than share a bed with him. How is it more comfortable on the floor?
Comfortable because I like to, I move around while I sleep. Y'all don't want to be a part of that.
I don't know if I trust what's been on the carpet in the hotel, man.
Well, that's true.
You're afraid that you're going to end up cuddling with the guy that you're sleeping with. Come clean.
You may turn over, forget where you're at.
Do we need to have your wife call in? Are you a nighttime cuddler? Are you afraid that you're going to get confused and think one of us is Kelly?
Mike in the Bronx.
I know I'm not touching the guy next to me. I will put a pillow, which is like the Berlin Wall, between the two of us, and there's no issues.
Well, put a pillow, and you guys have to turn butt to butt, and the pillow has to be on the butt.
The Berlin Wall came down, Clay. This Berlin Wall ain't coming down.
Mike,
I guarantee you.
Okay, I would vote for Kaharski and Frank due to the intellectual conversation that they'll have between that Columbia University degree and Frank's Maryland degree. And on top of it, I would like to have Clay have the other bed to tweet the conversation every night and make it a drinking game. Every time each one called each other cheap, tweet it, we take a shot.
That's actually a great idea. That's the best done so far. That would be an outstanding and awkward conversation, which all of you would probably love that I could tweet out.
Daryl in Hermitage. Hey, Daryl.
Hey. I'll tell you what, I'm going to make this real simple and easy for you. Right, I don't know who's going to sleep in the bed, who's going to sleep on the floor. All you do is get together and find out who had some beans within the last couple of days. That's automatic. You're sleeping on the floor, without a doubt.
What are you saying? Flatulence get you on the floor?
Yeah, that's right.
Flatulence is the least of my worries. That passes. The mayor cuddling me like I'm Kelly. I don't know if I'd ever get over that.
Rhett writes, Paul should get on the floor, the zone rookie initiation. Last one on the boat.
Oh, yeah.
Last one on the boat. Follow us on Twitter at 3HL1045. Individually at BBishop23. At Brent Doherty. At Clay Travis, BGID. At JT1045. Also on Facebook. 3HL is the group page. Most of these tweets are saying I can't even read.
Somebody put all the beds together.
About all this proposed. I like the big party in one room thing. That'd be kind of funny. With Clay tweeting the conversation and then the rest of us playing drinking games.
And Mark with the Super Bowl.
Mark's entertainment. Gets a little G-string going.
No. Mark's probably really upset with you now.
You know, no, I doubt that.
Close us out, Jay in Springfield. Hey, Jay.
Man, I've got the natural fit sleeping arrangements for the Super Bowl for you guys. Well, it's just natural. Blaine and Wycheck. I mean, they've already seen each other naked in the locker room.
Looking
at each other's junk, smacking each other on the butts. You know, it's a perfect fit.
All right, Jay.
Jay's locker room's a little more homoerotic than the one that I like to go to.
We'll never get these 3 hours back. You guys understand that?
smacking each other on the butt and looking at each other's junk? Is that what he does when he goes to the male locker room?
Brayden, if you ever need a guest on satellite radio, Claytron.
Chad Withrow will take all your calls now.
He'll be glad to describe that story of Baton Rouge on satellite radio. We'll be back tomorrow, 3 to 6. Stay tuned. Primetime Next, 104.5 The Zone. Thanks for listening.
Junk in the trunk.